So today we are going to remove these auxiliary lamps and put this thing on place of those things. It is a 120 watts LED bar. Now we'll see how to install it. So first thing, I've already made out a bracket to place this light bar. As you can see, my car has bump guards, so I have place to mount it. You have to really look into your car where you can place the light bar. I have tightened the bracket and I also tightened the bracket for the light bar. It's very easy, just an Allen key wrench and a different bolt. Same on this side. After installing the brackets of the light bar as well as on the guard, we have to look for the places from where the wiring is coming from. Wiring is going to come from. Observe your vehicle. Look into the firewall of vehicle. You'll find places from where wire can come from. You can route the wire. Preferably on driver's side. Look, I found a place behind the accelerator pedal in my car where it has a rubber grommet. I just pinched a hole in rubber grommet and route the wire through that. You can really route the wire from any way you want. Just take care of one thing, that wire doesn't go too close to the engine exhaust side, or it will get burnt and various things can happen. Look, I have routed all the way from accelerator pedal to through the firewall beneath the airbox and into the grill. As you can see, I have used a wire which is double, but actually you need a wire which is in thicker gauge, thicker than this wire. I am actually unable to source the wire at this time. That's why I'm using a double wire, using the both part of the wire as positive. You don't need to connect the negative, because the negative terminal of the ground is connected to the body of the car. You can source negative from any nearby bolt which is connected to the chassis. So don't waste your wire on putting a separate wire for negative. If you wanna use the light as direct, you can also route a separate wire from the positive of the battery to the switch you are going to place inside the car. So it will become direct no matter you have placed the key inside the ignition or not. I changed the wiring to a thicker gauge. I got the wire. Process is same, just change the wire. So my car has an empty switch slot just right to the steering column. I've also routed a wire directly from the battery so that I can switch it on or off regardless the key is in or not. Switch, place one wire here and this one here, and the job is complete. And this is the result.